Hey guys, I've got another video. Today is going to be me showing you how I made that little fun piece over there. I'll be putting on the reference image that I got inspiration from right over here. And it's pretty much me just getting inspiration from an image, and I think it's a good example to show because it's showing how I take inspiration rather than just copying. But from this image, what I really, really liked about it was that there was this cool kind of diamond placement of all these circular shapes, and I wanted to incorporate that into an image and kind of like really emphasize it. So I wanted to like push the circularness of this image, and it's really just a principle of shape language. So like, even though I really like that diamond placement of all these circular shapes, you know, it's her glasses, the smiley face, and then the ring, I also wanted to make sure that she felt soft. You know, she had this circular face, circular big eyes, and then she has these circular pom-poms kind of thing up in her hair. So I just wanted to really kind of emphasize that and make it kind of fun and poppy. I'm using Kyle Webster brushes to do the line art in this one, which I will definitely be linking. It's really a really great, great pack of brushes. It's a lot though, just be prepared that it's a lot of brushes, and I personally still have to go through all of them and decide which ones are my favorites, because it's a little bit of a nuisance to have all of them in your tool presets or your brush palette, and it just becomes a bit too hard to navigate through. So I recommend picking your favorites before or after you've got to play around with it a bit more. And so here I'm just starting out, you know, just continuing on the line art. I'm kind of trying to decide where I want thicker line weight versus thinner line weight. So to start, just my instinct was kind of telling me to make the hair feel a little bit more wispy and softer, so I decided to make it a little thinner. But you'll see later that I actually kind of changed my mind. But that's okay, you know, you kind of just go with your instinct, and this is kind of just a for fun image. And I kind of liked doing that, at least to start, because it gives me some kind of direction. But you'll see that I tend to go over the same area quite a bit while I'm doing my line art, because I'm going over the same thing and kind of trying to make a fluid line. So I would make a line, then undo, then make another line and undo, and I keep going and keep doing that until I like the line. At some point though, if I decide that it's close enough but I don't want to start all over again and try to keep making a line, I will select it, you know, using the lasso tool, and I would use the warp function. So if you right click, Command T or Control T, which is bringing up the transformation tools for whatever you're selecting, and then I would warp it into place pretty much, and it doesn't lose the integrity of the line. So I haven't really done that many line arts in my channel. I don't usually work with line art. I usually paint pretty fluidly. So I guess this is kind of the first time that you'll see like the way I work with line art. I'm kind of curious to see if there's more efficient ways, but this is the way I kind of learned from school. And I kind of like it doesn't bother me that I keep undoing and then redoing. The only thing though is that I sometimes will I go so fast, you know, that I like forget, or like I don't even realize that I made a good line art, and then I pretty much erase it and replace it with a bad one. But that is my own problem. That's me just like not being patient and not being, you know, like paying attention, I guess. So here now I'm starting to color. I just decided on a background that I wanted to start with. I really didn't have much plan when I was making this. I just kind of went with my gut. I wanted to do something fun and something not serious in a way. And there I'm doing the value checking again, where I fill the whole thing with white and then change the layer mode to color so that I can make sure that values are different without, you know, without the color, so I can make sure that everything is readable. And here I am, I'm still pretty obsessed with this pink, like super saturated pink color for skin. I don't know why, I'm just so attracted to it. Like, it's so different and it's really poppy. It's kind of like, this image kind of reminds me a little bit like Andy Warhol-esque type of really pop modern kind of art. So I don't know, I just had a lot of fun with that. I don't know, what do you guys think though? I mean, I'm having a lot of fun with this pink skin, and I kind of want to keep trying it in some other forms or maybe some other colors, but I also don't want this to just become like a weird gimmick, you know? So I'd love to hear what you guys think, so just let me know. So now I started out just leaving all my line art as the gray normal black color that I started out with, but here I'm starting to change each line art to whatever color that it corresponds to. So like the skin has like a darker pink, and then the hair has a darker blue. For the glasses though, I used masking rather than erasing what you're seeing right now, because masking is not destructive. So when you mask something, you're hiding it rather than erasing it, kind of like when you're using masking tape. So if anyone, I usually use that when I'm not sure how something is going to turn out. So that's just something I also recommend for you to use if you have something that you're like, oh, I don't know if this will turn out all right if I erase it. Because if you erase something, it's gone forever. If you mask it, it's still retrievable. Here, this is where you can see that I kind of changed my mind, because when I zoom out on the picture, you can't really even see the line art on the hair. So I decided that I wanted it to be thicker, and I ended up actually liking it a lot more when it's thicker. But yeah, you can see how I'm like going over the same thing over and over again sometimes. But like I said, I don't mind it. I think I still have fun doing that, and it feels really good when you get the perfect line. So yeah, give it a try. And I'm still cleaning up my lines here. I decided to also make the body more thick. And I guess her it's just to, like I said, to make it more poppy and more readable in general. Again, like, these colors are pretty crazy. I didn't have any concrete plans on what I was doing. I kind of just like went with my gut. But I don't know, I'm kind of happy with it. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with it. I think it ends up pretty cute. I'm pretty happy with also how the glasses turned out, because again, I didn't really have a huge plan for that. I just knew that I wanted her to have these kind of like hippie, transparent, you know, big round glasses. And she looks super shocked at you for some reason. And with her hand in front of her, like, what did you, like, I think you just said something really offensive to her pretty much. Here, I first tried to make the hair kind of painterly and having some kind of like a smoother transition, but I decided against it and made it a lot more flat like that, just because it didn't feel right. It just depends on the style you're going for, and I just didn't feel like something painterly super fit in with this, and I ended up liking it better when it's flat like this. So the way I do this though, just when it comes to shadows and shading. So with her hair and her body and stuff, she has form shadow. So meaning like there's parts that are darker because it's not being hit by the light. And that is really just a darker version of that color. Later on though, you'll see that I'm going to be putting in cast shadow, and that's gonna look very different from form shadow. So in general, how I like to differentiate the two is having two different colors for either shadow, because I think it makes for a more interesting image, and it's a bit more dimensional that you separate the two colors for the two different shadows. Of course, she's got these poppy little eyelashes that I like to incorporate. I think they're a lot of fun. Oh, I'm also trying to make the the ring a little bit transparent. It's just inspiration from the image that I had. And at first I was gonna put like some kind of peace sign or something on her forehead, but I decided to go with this guy just because he makes me laugh. Yeah, he's funnier to me. And I wanted to make sure that I had fun while I was doing this. So here I am incorporating what I was telling you about how the cast shadow is different from form shadow. And pretty much what I did was I made a new layer on top of everything and I set it to multiply. And then I color picked whatever was underneath. So where I was gonna have cast shadow on the wall, for example, I color picked the green. And so it was this like green on green multiply, and on the skin it's pink on pink multiply, the hair blue on blue. Sometimes I use purple, but today, I don't know, I just felt like this. Anyway, here's the final image. I hope you guys like it. I kind of thought it was a bit different than something that I usually do. I'm gonna be doing a little bit more experimentation on my channel, and I hope that's okay with you guys because I'm still kind of trying to find my unique voice. And so I hope you guys are okay with me taking you on this journey with me. Anyway, thanks for watching guys, and have a good night. Bye!